Oh, hello, fellow scientists. Sorry, I can't really talk right now. I am so hungry. So, I've decided to go straight to the source and make my own food from the sun's light. Oh. Not you too. Everyone passing by has been telling me that humans can't make food from the sun's energy, but I know plants can do it. So why can't I? Not fair. Well, I guess I'll have to come up with a new lunch plan, but how do plants make their own food from sunlight anyway? By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to explain how plants transform light energy into chemical energy through the process of photosynthesis. Let's get into it. Okay, so I know I'm not able to make my own food from sunlight, but now I'm wondering, how do plants do it? The answer to that question is one word: photosynthesis. That's a big word, but when we break it into pieces, the meaning of photosynthesis becomes clear. Photo means light, like the light from the sun. And synthesis means to combine things to make something new. So photosynthesis is how plants use sunlight to create something new, their food. Photosynthesis allows plants to transform the light energy from the sun into chemical energy stored as their food. Plants can then use that energy to grow. But how do they do it? It all starts with having the right ingredients. Plants need three key components for photosynthesis: water, carbon dioxide, a gas that makes up a large part of our atmosphere, and sunlight. Getting these components isn't as simple as picking them up from the grocery store. Plants have specialized structures for collecting everything they need for photosynthesis. The first component plants need is water. But how do they get that water from the environment to where it needs to be for photosynthesis? Roots! Plants have intricate systems of roots designed to spread out in the soil to soak up all the water plants need. The water is transported up from the roots through the stems and to the leaves of the plant. The plant has water, its first component. The next component, carbon dioxide, is found in the air. Similar to how animals need to breathe, plants breathe too. They take in air, including the carbon dioxide they need for photosynthesis, through pores in their leaves called stomata. So roots deliver the first component, water, and stomata allow for plants to breathe in the second component, carbon dioxide. Two components down. The last thing needed for photosynthesis is sunlight. While humans may talk about soaking up the sun, we can't actually harness the energy from the sun's light to use for ourselves the way plants can. The reason plants can absorb and use the sun's energy is because they have structures called chloroplasts. Inside those chloroplasts is a green pigment called chlorophyll, which is what gives green plants their color by reflecting green light. Chlorophyll absorbs the light energy from the sun, giving the plant its third component. The plant can then use that light energy to power a chemical reaction between the water and the carbon dioxide. That reaction between them creates glucose, a type of sugar that plants use as food. So, by combining the water absorbed by their roots, the carbon dioxide taken in through the stomata on their leaves, and the light energy absorbed by the chlorophyll in their chloroplasts, plants are able to make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. Now that you know a lot more about this process, pause the video here and complete the diagram in your guided notes. With the energy gained through photosynthesis, plants are able to do things like grow larger, produce the flowers that help them in the production of new seeds, and grow fruits that help to spread those seeds. Photosynthesis isn't just important to plants, though. Plants' ability to transform light energy also has a huge impact on their ecosystems, or all the other living and non-living things in their area. When plants undergo photosynthesis, the reaction between carbon dioxide and water doesn't just create glucose. Oxygen is also created. Because the plants don't need the oxygen, they release it through their stomata into the atmosphere. Plants are the reason there is oxygen in the air for animals to breathe. Without oxygen, we wouldn't be here to talk about plants and photosynthesis. But even that's just the beginning of what plants do for their ecosystems. As I've now learned, humans and other animals do not have the ability to use photosynthesis to get energy directly from the sun. Instead, they get energy by eating the plants that do have the ability to transform the sun's energy. Because of this, plants are at the beginning of every ecosystem's food web, kicking off the spread of energy to all living things. That gives me an idea of what I should have for lunch. While I prepare that, let's review everything we've learned today. Plants get energy through photosynthesis. To do this, they need three components: water, carbon dioxide, and sunlight. Plants have specialized structures for collecting each component. The combination of these components creates glucose for the plant and releases oxygen into the atmosphere. To find out more about how plants get energy, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. As for me, I just whipped up a tasty fruit salad for lunch. It's so juicy and sweet. It tastes like it's bursting with the sun's energy. Thanks so much for joining me today. And remember, science is all around us. See you next time.